Hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty. It's Artcast 540, and something wrong with my phone. Look at that thing. I mean, the screen's broke, but the battery was dead this morning. It didn't wake me up. Like, the alarm didn't go off. And it won't hold the charge now, so I don't know what's going on with it. I think it's busted. Let's do some art. Let's get some drawing done. So today I'm doing some sketches. I'm sketching some Berserkonaut pages. Not for the comic, though. I signed up to do the 100 Days of Comics Anthology that's going to come out later this year. It's a kind of like a graphic novel compilation sort of book with a bunch of the guys that have done the 100 Days of Comics Challenge. So we're all doing like 4-page stories, and there's probably like 20 artists in this whole thing, and then, you know, the 100 Days of Comics group is going to like publish the book. So anyway, I'm signed up for my 4 pages, so I need to sketch out my little 4-page story. And the theme of the book is unicorns and werewolves. Sorry, the heater just started, so hopefully that doesn't mess the audio up too much. But anyway, I'm going to draw a werewolves and unicorn themed Berserkonaut story and put it in there. It's going to be like a black and white story. It's going to be very cool, very fun, I think. So anyway, this is how I always start the stories. I always, you know, write like a loose script, and then I sketch out the book on index cards. So that's what I'm doing here. I thought maybe I'd read some comments. Got some good comments on the last couple of videos. So let's see what we got here. Terrain Mancer said, trolling is such a negative drain on artists. Just create your art. No need to tear others down. You've always been a class act, Jeff. Keep up the great work. So I appreciate that. And he left that on the old Holly Brown video there. Lots of Holly Brown comments. I think I accidentally stepped in a bear trap when I talked about that. Kind of like Comics Gate. I didn't realize it was like such a big, you know, issue on YouTube. Dan Ekas, who I talked about in the last video, says, thanks for the shout out. I'm going to link this video in the description for the one I did. I did talk about painting goals with a schedule in my vid as well, but I hope I stressed that enough. Yeah, by the time I was talking about the goals and stuff, I really wasn't talking about Dan's video anymore. I just kind of was my take on kind of that self-help kind of stuff. So I hope he didn't think I was actually like saying, hey, you're doing this wrong, Dan, because that wasn't my point. I just was kind of using that video as a jumping off point. So here's another Holly Brown comment. Bubbleus says, to be fair, she's a bully. She puts down other people and passes it off as a joke, or being really honest, and never truthfully apologizes other than saying, I'm sorry I got caught. Yeah, that could be. A lot of people do that on YouTube, I notice. A lot of people kind of stir up trouble, and then when they get in trouble, they kind of go like, oh, whoops. Eric Messenger, he says, I'm with you. I get asked the same question over and over. How do you get good? I always answer hard work. Yeah, that's the truth, man. You can't get around that. Jibben Redinger says, great video, great advice. I got a question. How many drawings do you normally crank out in a week or on average? So Jibben Redinger, I don't know if you guys noticed, but he was doing the 100 Days of Comics. I don't know if he finished the 100 Days of Comics or not. He might have dropped off, but he actually finished his comic, which is like ridiculous. That's awesome. And so I hope that he's going to print it somewhere, print on demand or something, to kind of get at least a couple copies out there so I can buy one at least, you know. He's put all this hard work into making a comic. I'd at least like to pick it up for sure. I'm sure there's other people that would buy a few copies. So, you know, maybe even like a little Kickstarter, Indiegogo or something. But that's awesome. I mean, you know, super proud of that guy for accomplishing that, you know. Whether you got done with the 100 Days of Comics or not, I mean, the main thing is to get your comic done. So either way, I think he succeeded. But as far as like how many pieces I crank out in a week, man, it just so depends. You know, it's like bigger pieces versus smaller pieces. And it also depends how busy I am. I might just be, you know, working on my comic. I mean, my goal is like a page a week with my comic, but like I said in the last video, I fell off that because I've been doing so many sketches in the beginnings of these comics. But yeah, like usually I try to get a page a week of my comic done. And in general, you know, my pages are 3 to 4 paintings, you know. And then on top of that, I got my commission works. I try to do like a one a week at this point, but that's kind of like slowed down from my usual amount. But then like the kinds I've been getting lately have been more like some of these like Amazon book cover type deals and stuff like that. And some portraits, but you know, like the portraits don't take as long because you just go right into painting them. But then like with some of the book cover type things, it's like you got to do sketches, and then, you know, there's going to be maybe changes. And I don't know, I've been doing some like black and white drawings for some of these guys, and you know, those are like a day. And it's like, I guess I just don't really have an answer, but you know, maybe 5 pieces in a week in general, I would imagine, of, you know, just variety of type stuff, you know, comic book work and also the portrait type stuff. So I was thinking, after I did the last video, I was thinking about, you know, the whole thing about, you know, just buckling down and kind of like taking a section of time and saying like, this section of time is for this, you know, like what I was saying with the comic, you know. And I pretty much already do that. I kind of divide my day into like 4-hour blocks. So like 1 4-hour block is kind of like the portraiture type stuff, that kind of thing, my what I call my illustration work. And then like the other 4-hour block is like my comic stuff. But I was thinking, you know, could I, and this is just nuts, but it's like, could I work in the animation in there somewhere? Because I love doing animation, you know, and I miss doing it. And I feel like even though I got that one chunk of my animated, you know, story done, it's like I didn't really get like the whole thing done. And I was thinking, like, if I cut it down, if I, like, shrunk it down a little bit and then just tried to get, like, another, say, like, 8 episodes out, could I actually finish it? Could I do it with, like, say, if I did 3-hour blocks, maybe, like, 3, 6, 9, that's only a 9-hour day. That's not, like, anything that's unusual for most people. Most people spend that at work anyway. Or maybe keep it at 4 and try to push to 12 hours. Maybe I should do like 100 days of comics, but it's like 100 days of my comics art and animation. I don't even want to say that out loud. That sounds so hard. I don't know. A lot of doing these projects, I think, is committing, you know. It's like once you kind of commit and then you drop off, and it's so hard to get back in that mindset of like, okay, I'm going to do like this much more work. But if you don't do it, you know, it doesn't get done. It doesn't come to fruition, you know. It's like there's only one person that's going to do my animation, and that's me, you know what I mean? Nobody else is going to do it. If I don't do it and I croak, you know, that's it. It just never got done, you know. So that's like everything, you know, with my art and everything in my comics, you know. It's sort of like nobody else is going to come along and do them for me, so I'm the only one who can do them. So I guess it just depends, like, how important it is to me. Anyway, that's it for today. And a Patreon, you know, support the channel. Berserkonaut is at Indiegogo still. It's on demand, so, you know, buy one, it'll get there in a few days. And what's the next thing? Oh, mailing list. Sign up for the mailing list. I'll send you notifications every time a new video comes out. And see you guys next time.